Hey YouTube! This is Super Zemison! Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy III! Alright, last time we made it to the top of the Tower of Owen and Medusa's trying to destroy the... or drop the continent of the sky! Or the floating continent, whatever! But anyway, who's this Sir Zand? Remember him for later. Oh, I don't think so, Medusa! I didn't know Medusa was a giant floating head. Anyway, let's fight Medusa. She's actually pretty easy. She can't cast Break, which that will, obviously stone you. But it rarely hits. If not, it never hits. So don't worry about that. Just attack and go out with all out with your most powerful magic. I suggest Ice too, personally. That's just me. And, might as well have the Freezing Staff or Burning Staff. I have nothing better to do for Repia. Oh, I guess she could have cast a row, but... Nah, it's ineffective. Whatever. You're ineffective! Yeah, see, Break rarely hits. I think she can cast some sort of powerful magic. Yeah, even the most powerful magic of, what is it? Arc barely hits. So, it can be bad. I guess, yeah, why not? Just use Arrow. Not really gonna be using that, spell charges for anything else, so... So far, we're doing pretty good. Anyway, yep, there goes that. Ice 2. Alright, yeah, that's a bit better there, Ark. Good, good. Another Ice 2 will do. And, another Arrow. Yeah, really you just want, really it's up to Lunith and Ingus to finish this battle, because they're doing the majority of the damage. Ha! I knew Medusa was easy, but I didn't think she was that easy! Yeah, that's pretty much all there is to the boss fight, just keep attacking. She's barely gonna be doing anything to you, but... Uh-oh! Remember what the Gurgan said in the last episode, where, if there's a red-hot flame at the top of the tower, it means the tower's about to... or the floating continent's about to crash? Oh, we gotta do something about that! Oh, no, no, no. Oh, alright, let's go check it. Let's go check it. That's not good. It's dangerous! What do you think you're doing, Desh? Oh, okay. I'm glad you remembered that. Ah, remember what the Gurgan said? About, when the Tower of Owen's getting destroyed, well, the Guardian will awaken? Well, that's Desh! Oh, alright then. Well, what are you doing, Desh? What do you think you're gonna do? Well, I know that's a problem, but you're gonna get incinerated! Big furnace with wings. In a second, poof, a pile of ashes. Nah, nah. What do you think you're doing, Desh? That's not a good idea. Uh-oh. Well, I already see where this is going. Bye, Desh, you lived a very good life. Oh, alright, remember, let's go to the Island of the Dwarves. We'll do that after Desh destroys himself. Oh, alright, alright. No, Desh! Whoa, you can jump, man! Desh. Oh well, he lived a good life. Now let's get out. Guys, come on, let's get out of here! No, we don't need to... Alright, we need to wait for Desh to warp us out. Unfortunately, I'll just tell you now, viewers, this is the death music. I don't know why they did this, but the death music has to play out for like 30 seconds until you can start moving again. This is for all deaths in this game. Pretty stupid, but oh well, we got out. Easy enough. So, now that that's over with, I guess we'll fight some more new enemies! Gorgons! The guys in the front are Gorgons. These guys are easy, and the flyers in the back are weak to Arrow. Oh yeah, and the Gorgons, I believe, are weak to Lightning. Not that I care, I'm too cheap to actually use my magic. Oh, well, I guess flyers can do that. Not that I actually care. Alright guys, come on, let's just take them out. Oh, come on, Luneth! I know you can do better than that! Ah, jeez. Alright, keep going after those Gorgons till you kill them off. Oh, come on! I do not remember these flyers using those, that glare ability so much. Can't even kill that Gorgon. You guys are disappointing. All I wanted was to get to the Dwarven Hollows, but no! I have to show off more new enemies! Guys suck, you know. You guys suck hard. Oh, jeez, you're taking a beating there, Luneth. Well, at least we got one Gorgon down. I can't kill even off... Can't even kill off that Gorgon. Anyway, that takes care of that Gorgon. And let's take care of these flyers now. They're a bit annoying. Alright, Ingus, woke up. That'll help out a lot. Ooh, and Ark woke up too. Nice timing, guys. Nice timing. Now we can take out these freaking flyers. As long as they don't cast glare again. Oh, come on, Ingus! You guys are really disappointing me today. Well, I guess I shouldn't complain. I got rid of Medusa in within like 2 minutes. Which is average time. It's just... Well, I was thinking it would be like 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Guys... Can you just kill them off for me? I don't want to be in this battle for 10 years. I want to kind of... Seriously, I think I have a beard growing right now, guys. Thank you. Okay, let's get out of here. That took forever. Well, now that we're done with that, let's go to the Dwarven Hollows. Oop. Dwarven Hollows! Just go north and then all the way west here and make it to a little island over here. Go in here, make it to, well, the Dwarf Cave. That was Dwarven Hollows. I call it Dwarven Hollows. Yay! Lolly-ho! Oh, I love Lolly-ho. It's in the... Oh, well, it wasn't in the original Final Fantasy 1, but in Dawn of Souls it was in there. Lolly-ho! No, it was in Final Fantasy 4. Guzco. Huh. This Guzco guy doesn't sound too good. Can't forgive him. Nope. Lolly-lolly-ho! Never heard that one before. Well, the more lollies, the better. Nah, I think I prefer just one lolly-ho. Oh, this is a revivification pool, by the way. But if we go down here, well, there's a rock blocking the path, so we can't do anything about that just yet. Oh, let's look around, shall we? Talk to more dwarves, shall we? I bet I could go. Ouch! Jeez, man. Not as bad as the flame from a candle. That hurt. Ouch! Gisaw. Yeesaw. Yeehaw! No. Oh, well, remember that for later. Well, if we go in here, then we can rest up, which I actually want to do. Let's rest up, shall we? Kinda took a beating there. Yeah, no more dash. Oh well. Yeah, viewers, that's probably one of the longest party members you'll have, so... yeah, most of them will probably only last, like, 2 episodes, and that's it. For this one, this guy lasted, like, 5 episodes. Desh was with us for a long time. Here we have the weapon shop, and the armor shop's right there, but the weapons and armor are very expensive, so I'm not gonna be buying stuff there just yet. For now, let's just go on to this, this cave they were talking about. Well, over here. Oh, again, I have to turn into a toad again. Alright, nothing better to do. Alright. Let's get toad going, shall we? And if we're all toaded, yay! We make it to the underground lake. So, now let's return back to normal. This is actually a pretty easy area, so... It's actually a relatively low encounter rate as well. Probably should knock on wood. Kinda don't wanna speak too soon. I know the Super Zemus has a nasty habit of speaking too soon. Anyway, here we get a soft potion. Never have enough of those. Love those soft potions. And if we keep going down here, it's actually a pretty short dungeon, too. Find some new enemies. Here we have manticores. They can cast ice on you, so, watch out for that. Oh, and lots of enemies here can also turn you to stone. Not the manticore, per se, but lots of other enemies can, so it's a good thing they're giving you those soft potions in case that happens. Anyway, these guys go down easy enough, as long as your fighters are in tip-top shape. Good job, guys, good job. Anyway, let's see. Yeah, but these enemies are starting to give you a lot more experience. That's nice. I guess Zeus's rage, not that I'll ever use it. Oh, and here's another new enemy, boulders! I believe these guys can turn you to stone if I remember correctly, but I could be wrong. Yep, I was right, never mind. Wow! Ouch! Both of them got turned to stone. Wow, I have never seen that happen before. Well, let's put those soft potions to use, I guess. Oh, wow, I don't have a lot. Thought I had a lot more than those. Oh, well, we'll be getting quite a few of them in this dungeon, so let's break that stonage that they have. Thankfully, Boulder did not cast Glare again. I would have been mad if he did. So, finish off this Boulder, Ingus. Thank you. What? Okay, Lunith, you can do that. That works. Wow, I have never seen that happen. Usually only one party member gets stoned. I never see two party members get stoned. That was weird. Unlucky for me, though. Anyway, another Zeus's Rage. Not that I actually care. Don't really care for battle items, except for the South Winds, and later on the North Winds. Those are actually pretty good. Now, if I remember correctly, I think there's just about one, maybe two more new enemies in this area. I get another soft potion, alright. Replenishing on that stock. Anyway, this is the last floor. I think there's one more new enemy on this floor, if I remember correctly. Anyway, get 300 gil, alright. Just keep going north here. And oh, here's the new enemy. Unfortunately, I got back attacked. Hate it when that happens. Game! Well, I'll just tell you, the mermans in the back there, they're weak to thunder. I'm just gonna run because I don't want to deal with these guys. Guys, thank you. Now I have to use a soft potion again. Alright, Ark, there you go. I'll just tell you now, I'm not going to show off the mermans, they're just weak to thunder, I'll just tell you now. I get another 300 gil, alright. Now before talking to this guy, I want to heal up. Spoiler alert, it's a boss! Alright, good enough, alright. Guzco at last! Now we have to fight Guzco. This guy is actually pretty easy. I mean, he likes to cast level 2 elemental spells, but not too bad, not too bad. I suggest using Ice 2 again. And, you know what? Why don't you use Arrow there? Raphia? Really? Again, this is just like the fight with Medusa. You just want to leave the battling to Ingus and Lunith, because they're going to be dealing the majority of the damage. Yeah, unfortunately, can't really deal much damage to Guzco with, yeah, most of the bosses are just getting really good with their magic defense, so honestly, magic is not too good in this game. I mean, cure magic is pretty good, but, honestly, regular black magic, once you get past, really this part of the game, it starts not being too good. I'll still be using it for a while, but, really it's just not as good anymore. Anyway, another Ice 2, I guess, and, last arrow spell I can cast, and Ingus, you can attack. Should almost have Guzco. Doesn't have too much HP. It's actually a pretty easy boss. I'd say he's just a bit stronger than, Medusa, which is to be expected because he's after Medusa as a boss. They're supposed to get stronger. What did you expect? Alright, do I have any more? Alright, still have a little more there. Refia, you're done for attacking. You're done for, using arrow, so... No, still don't have him? Alright, then. Ow! That hurt. Probably want to heal up. Yeah, start using bolt there, arc. And, yeah, I want you to use Cure 2 on Lunith there. That hurt a bit. Alright, got Guzco. Good job, Ingus. Yeah, pretty easy boss there. A bit stronger than Medusa, but still pretty easy. Alright, but for defeating Guzco, we get the Dwarf Horn. Alright. Now we can progress. Why don't we head back and give that to him, but... Oh, that's interesting. What's that white line that's following us? Yeah, it's in our party, but I have no idea what it is. Eh, I'm sure it's nothing. I just ignore it. I bet it's just a glitch. That's it! Anyway, let's just cast exit. Just warp outside. And go back in. So I don't have to go through the rest of the subterranean cave. Not that the enemies are that hard. It's just I don't want to get petrified. I only have a limited supply of those soft potions. Anyway, let's go give that, the dwarf horn back. Alright, you do that, dwarfy. Alright, you got it. Yep, yes. Alright, so let's give them the horn back. Where is it? Is it here? There it is. There we go. Alright. Nice seeing... What's going on? What the? Guzco! You don't know when to give up, do you? Well, that's not good. He got both the horns now. Nuts. What do you plan on doing with them, Guzco? Uh-oh. Can't allow him to get the power of the fire. Oh, jeez, man. Epic. He can walk through walls. Alright. Oh, I might talk to a few of the dwarves. Terrible, terrible. Terrible ho. Lolly, lolly ho. Uh-oh. Well, we better stop him. Yeah, now they basically say the exact same thing. So, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna heal up. Why not? Alright, back to happy music. Yay! Well, I guess it's not really happy music, but it's not epic music like that was. Just scared me. Well, we gotta do something about Guzco. But what are we gonna do about Guzco? Will we be able to stop him before he gets to the, Crystal of Fire? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy III. This is Super Zenus, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.